Hello friends, welcome to my channel Animated Study. If you have played with bubbles, you can see bubble have a tendency, that's bubble are moving in the direction of wind. Similarly, in some sorting algorithm, we are comparing the elements and exchanging the elements in a such a way that smaller elements is bubbled up to the front of the list and bigger element bubbled to the end of the list. Such kind of sorting is known as bubble sort. Let's see how the bubble sort works. So here you have an array A, and array have a 6 element started from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and these are the random numbers that we want to sort. So we will making the functions like this, in which we are passing the array and number of elements. Then we are sorting the elements using this code. So let's understand it line by line. So in bubble sort, we are starting with comparing first two elements. And if first elements is smaller than the next elements, we don't require to do anything. Then we will compare the next two elements. If first element is bigger than the next elements, we have to swap the element. Then we will check the next two elements. At the same way, once the first element is bigger than the next element, we have to swap the element. And in this way, we are doing first pass. So at the end of the first pass, you will get the biggest element at the end. Then we are doing the next pass. Same process we are repeating. And after end of the second pass, we are getting second highest elements at the second last positions of the list. And so on. Let's we see these algorithms in detail. So here we are calling the bubble sort algorithm, in which we are passing the array A, an integer n, that is the size of array. So we have a n is equal to 6, that is number of elements that we want to sort. Now we are defining the variables, and here we are taking flag is equal to 0. So you can see over here in our variable window, flag we are taking for the special purpose. Initially we are taking as a 0. When we are swapping the elements in any pass, we are take it as a 1. Swapping shows that there is an unsorted list. In any pass, if there is no single swap is happened, it means your array is sorted. And at that time, you return from the functions. So this is optimized algorithms. So when you find there is a no swap in entire pass, it means the element sorted, and then no next passes are required, and you can return from the functions. Now you are going into the for loop. You are taking I is equal to 0, I less than n minus 1. Here n is equal to 6, so n minus 1, that is 5. I is 0, so 0 is less than 5, so condition true. Here you have a one question, that is why you are taking n minus 1. So here we have to do the passes, that is n minus 1. So if you have a 6 elements, you don't require to do the 6 passes. Because if you are doing 5 passes, remaining one element is always sorted. So if you are doing the 5 passes instead of 6, you will have a one element left. So you don't require to sort the one element. So you can take n minus 1 instead of n. Now you are taking flag is equal to 0. In this case, it is already 0. Then you are taking inner for loop in which you are taking j as a 0. And then you are checking condition j less than n minus 1 minus I. So your n is equal to 6. 6 minus 1, that is 5. 5 minus I, that is 0, so 5. So 0 less than 5. So condition true. Here again you have one question. So why you are taking n minus 1 minus I? So I have said earlier, after one pass, you will get the biggest element at the end of the list. In second pass, you have a second highest or second biggest element is at the second last positions of the list. So when your passes are progresses, you don't require to do the repetitions for the entire list. So passes by passes, you require to compare lesser and lesser elements. That is why we are taking j less than n minus 1 minus I. So in first pass, your j will goes up to the 5. In second pass, you have to check up to the 4. In third pass, you have to check up to the 3 and so on. That means bigger elements are bubbled to the right side. Now you are comparing aj is greater than aj plus 1. So here you can see aj is equal to 23. Aj plus 1 is a 98. So aj is not greater than aj plus 1. So condition false. So again you are incrementing the j. That is now 1. 1 is less than 5. So condition true. So again you are checking aj is greater than aj plus 1. So now you can say ajth elements, that is 98, and j plus 1 element is 11. So here you can say aj is greater than aj plus 1. So condition true. So we are going inside the condition. We are taking temporary is equal to aj. So here you can say temporary value is equal to 98 now. And we are taking aj is equal to aj plus 1. So since aj plus 1 is 11, so now aj is 11 here. Now again you are changing the value. Aj plus 1 is equal to temp. So here temp you can see is 98. So now aj plus 1 is equal to temp. So you can see this three lines is doing nothing, but it is exchanging or swapping the elements aj and aj plus 1. So now onwards we will take these three lines together and we will just swap the elements. Now here you have swapped the value. It's indicate the list is not sorted. That's why you are taking flag is equal to 1. So you can see over here flag is equal to 1. Now you are incrementing the j by 1. So now j is equal to 2. 2 is less than 5. Again you are checking aj greater than aj plus 1. So you will check here 98 and 45. So you can see 98 is greater than 45. So you have to swap the elements. So we are taking these three lines together because it is doing simply swapping of the elements. So you can see here we are swapping the elements. Now we are swapping. You take flag is equal to 1. In this case flag is already 1. Again you are incrementing the j. J is now 3. 3 is less than 5. That is n minus 1 minus I. You can see here it is 5. So 3 is less than 5. So again we will check aj is greater than aj plus 1. So here you can say 98 is greater than 62. So again this condition is true. So you require to swap. You are swapping 62 and 98. Again you are taking flag is equal to 1. That is already 1. Now you are incrementing the j by 1. So now j is equal to 4. 4 is less than n minus 1 minus I, that is 5. 4 is less than 5. Condition true. So you are again checking the conditions. Aj greater than aj plus 1. Here you can say AJ is 98, AJ plus 1 is 35. So 98 is greater than 35. So condition true. So again we will swap with this code. So 98 and 35 will be swapped. Now your flag is equal to 1. Now you increment J by 1 again. And you can see here J is equal to 5. And N that is 6 minus 1 that is 5 minus I that is 0. So N minus 1 minus I that is 5. 5 less than 5, condition false. So we are coming out of the inner loop and we will check this conditions. Flag is equal to 0. Since here flag is equal to 1, so we are doing nothing here and increment the I by 1. So now you can see here I is equal to 1. And this is the completion of the first pass. At the end of first pass, you can see 98 is bubbled down to the last position of the list. Now, so in the next pass, you are taking the first 5 elements for considerations for sorting. That is why N minus 1 minus I is important in the case. Now again, you are taking flag is equal to 0. In the inner loop, you are taking J is equal to 0. You are checking the conditions. J is less than N minus 1 minus I. So here N is equal to 6 minus 1 that is 5 minus I that is 1 that is 4. So now onwards, your J is running from 0 to 4. That is up to 35 only. Because now you don't require to go up to 98. Because 98 is already fixed at its last positions. Now here you are checking the condition. AJ greater than AJ plus 1. Since J is equal to 0, AJ is pointing to 23. AJ plus 1 is pointing 11. So here you can say 23 is greater than 11. So condition true. So again we will swap the element. And you can see here 11 and 23 is swapped. So here you can see we are taking flag is equal to 1. Now you increment the J by 1, that is 1 less than 4, condition true. Check the another condition. AJ is greater than AJ plus 1, so 23 is greater than 45. Condition false. So again go into the for loop, increment J by 1, 2 is less than 4, condition true. Again you are taking AJ and AJ plus 1, that is 45 and 62. It is already in sorted order, no requirements of any swapping here. Again you increment the J by 1, now J is equal to 3, 3 is less than 4, condition true. So you check AJ greater than AJ plus 1. So here you can see 62 is greater than 35. So here you can understand swapping is required. So condition true. So you are swapping the 62 and 35. And you are taking flag is equal to 1. Now you check these conditions. That is J, that is now 4. 4 less than N minus 1 minus I. You can see here N minus 1 that is 5 minus 1 that is 4. So J is equal to 4. N minus 1 minus I is equal to 4. So 4 less than 4. Condition false. So we'll coming out of the loop. We will check flag is equal to 0. Still flag is not equal to 0. So we are going ahead for the next pass. And here at the end of this pass, you can see 62 is coming to its final position. So we have shaded it with the green colors. So now you have a blue list that is unsorted and green list that is sorted list. So after completion of every pass, you have a lesser and lesser element required to compare. Now again, you are incrementing I by 1, that is 2 now. And you are checking 2 is less than 5. That is N minus 1. So condition true. So you are taking flag is equal to 0. So here you can see flag is equal to 0. Now in the inner for loop, you are taking j is equal to 0. J is equal to 0. Check the conditions j less than n minus 1 minus I. Here n minus 1, that is 5, minus I. So minus 2, that is 3. So 0 less than 3, condition true. So you are going inside the loop and you are checking conditions. Aj greater than Aj plus 1. Here Aj is 11. Aj plus 1 is 23. So condition false. So we are moving ahead. We are increment j by 1. So now j is equal to 1. So 1 is less than 3. Condition true. So again we will check Aj greater than Aj plus 1. That means 23 greater than 45. Condition false. So again we will increment j by 1. So now j is equal to 2. N minus 1, that is 5, minus I, that is 2. So 3. 2 less than 3. Condition true. So again you are going inside the loop. You are checking Aj, that is 45, greater than Aj plus 1, that is 35. So 45 is greater than 35. Condition true. So we are going for swapping. And we will swap 35 and 45. When swapping is done, we have to take flag is equal to 1. Now you are increment j by 1, that means j is equal to 3. Now j is less than n minus 1 minus I, that is 3. So 3 less than 3, condition false. So we are coming out of the for loop and check the condition. If flag is equal to 0, that is false here. So we'll not returning from here. We are going to the outer for loop and increment I by 1. So now I is equal to 3. You can see here. So 3 is less than 5, that is n minus 1. Condition true. So again we'll taking flag is equal to 0. And then we will go inside the inner loop. And we are checking j is less than n minus 1 minus I. So since j is equal to 0, n minus 1 minus I, that is 2 here. So 0 less than 2, condition true. So we are checking Aj greater than Aj plus 1. So Aj is 11, Aj plus 1 is 23. So condition false. So we'll increment j by 1. So now j is equal to 1. 1 less than 2, condition true. So again we are checking the condition. Aj is greater than Aj plus 1, that means 23 is greater than 35. Condition false. Increment j by 1. Now j is equal to 2. N minus 1 minus I is also 2. So 2 less than 2. Condition false. So we are coming out of the inner for loop and check this condition. So here you can see if flag is equal to 0. Now you can see here from the variable list flag is equal to 0. So condition true. So we are returning from the functions. That means it shows that if flag is equal to 0, that means we have done not a single swapping in the entire pass. That means all elements are sorted now. So now you don't require to go for the next pass. And you have an entire list is sorted now. So if you see the running time of the algorithm, in the best case, that means if you have an entire list in sorted order, then you are going into the first pass. And in first pass, you are taking flag is equal to 0. Then you are going into the inner loop. And in inner loop, you are checking every time Aj greater than Aj plus 1. And every time your condition goes false. So So no swapping will be done if list is given in sorted order. That means you are running this loop only one time. And since you have a flag is equal to 0, you are coming here and flag is equal to 0 and you are returning from the functions. So here in the best case, the time complexity of bubble sort is big O n. Now if you are checking about the worst case, that means the list is given in the reverse order. You are running this for loop n minus 1 time, and in that n minus 1 time you are running the inner loop for every time, that is n minus 1 minus I times. And if you see, every condition will go true. So every time you require to swap, so at least your loop will run for n minus 1 multiply by n minus 1 minus I. So if you multiply this, you are getting higher order term, that is n multiply by n, that is n square. So in worst case, bubble sort algorithm time complexity is big O n square. You are comparing the elements and swapping the elements on an average half times. So again you are getting n square. So your time complexity for average case, that is also big O n square. Here this is in place sorting algorithms. So space complexity is big O 1. That means you don't require to any extra space or any extra memory for sorting using bubble sort. So space complexity you can write as a big O 1. So now you can analyze the algorithm pass by pass. So here you have all elements and here you have all passes. So after end of the first pass, your entire list condition is like this, and you can see here 98 is fixed its position. In pass 2, what you are doing ultimately using this algorithm, 23 and 11 you will compare. So 11 and 23 will be swapped. 23 and 45 is compared. No swapping is required. Then you are taking 45 and 62. No swapping is required. 62 and 35, and you will swap it. So you are getting 62 here. In third pass, what you have done, you can visualize here, 11 and 23 you have compared, 23 and 45 you have compared, then 45 and 35 you have compared. Here you can see 35 is less than 45, so you have to swap these two and you will get 35 here and 45 here. So here you have fixed these three elements at the end of list. In the fourth pass, you have checked 11 and 23, no swapping is required, and then you have seen 23 and 35, no swapping is required. So 35 position will be fixed. And here we have not done any single swapping, so your flag will work. And here you can see our flag is equal to 0. So from here, you don't require to go to the next pass. So you can see your bigger elements is bubbled down to the end of the list, and smaller elements are gradually bubbled up to the front of the list. And this is what about the bubble sort. So if you like my video, please subscribe the channel and share the video to your friends, and don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thank you for watching.